Canada.
Hi loves, happy Sunday. Welcome back to Grace and Mercy Family. Today my title is Keep Your Joy Even When Things Are Not Going Right or When Things Are Going Right. Still keep your joy. Everyone is not going to like you. I want you to understand this for the rest of your life. Everyone is not going to like you, and everyone is not going to hate you. There are people out there who are going to see you and dislike you for no reason. And there are also people out there who's going to love you for no reason. They will just see you and just love everything about you and just love your spirits. You know, they don't even know you. And even family member, they can love you, or it can be friends who, or family member who can just dislike you for no reason. For somehow they think that you're better than them. You didn't think that you're better than them. If that's what they have in their mind, they think that you're better than them. So get that in your mind, that everybody's not going to like you. Everyone is not going to hate you. My question is, are you upset because someone is not for you? Are you upset? Don't be upset, because sometimes God has ordained them for them not to be there for you. So that way God can get the glory. And you know they say God does not share his glory with any man. God allow those things to happen to you, or for those people to do you like that, so God can get the glory. So quit being bitter. I want to say sour, but quit being bitter because someone betray you, or that best friend betray you, or that family member, or someone close to you betray you. So now you all bitter and sour because that person betray you. Honey, let it go. That's not the end of your destiny. Learn from that and move on. Enjoy your life. Be you. Keep your joy. Don't let nobody else steal your joy, honey. Keep it. You know? Don't give them your joy because they don't like you. Don't give them your joy because they don't like you. They not liking you have nothing to do with your destiny. It does not have anything to do with your destiny because they do not like you. Stay focused on what God has called you to do. It's just like Joseph in the Bible, Joseph the dreamer. His brothers did not like Joseph, but it did not stop Joseph's destiny. When Joseph told them he had a dream, they said, who he think he is? He think we all would just bow down to him? They did all that. They put their brother in a pit, and then they took him out. They said, nah, take him out. And then they sold him to slavery. They thought that was the end of Joseph's life. For y'all that knows the story of Joseph in the Bible, they thought that was the end of Joseph's life, but it was not. What they meant for evil, God turned it to good. Joseph became the prime minister in Egypt. He went through all type of stuff. It was not easy for Joseph. He was in prison. It was a false allegation they made against him. The lady that tried to sleep with Joseph, when Joseph said no, she said, false allegation against Joseph to her husband. Joseph was in prison, all that stuff. But Joseph kept his eye on God. He did not give up. And at the end of the day, Joseph becomes somebody great in life. And those who looked down on Joseph, they came and bowed down to Joseph. Did not even know it was Joseph. Just like how Joseph had a dream. So don't be upset because somebody is not there for you. They hate you. Let them hate you. It's not going to stop your destiny that God has planned for you. All the challenge, I would say trials and tribulation. All the trials and tribulation that have comes your way is a distraction. It's to get you upset, to keep you away from God, and to try to destroy your destiny. So I want you to know that it's just to distract you. So you can keep your eye away from God. You'll be asking, oh God, why this, why this, why that? It's just like Joe in the Bible. Joe lost everything. People were saying, curse God. His wife said, curse God. J- Joseph, not Joseph, but Job's children all die in the Bible, they say. But Job never gave up on God. And I love that. And at the end of the day, they say, God blessed Job. I keep saying Joseph. God blessed Job more than what he had at his beginning. So your beginning might not be the greatest, but your ending will be the greatest. I believe that, and I have faith. So quit letting people just get you all upset, all mad. Be happy, child of God. Quit letting the same thing upset you all the time. When you let people upset you, you're giving them power, and it's true. All the time, like I hear a sister tell me, oh my God, I'm always mad about this. I don't know. I'm just so angry. You don't understand, Hannah. When she do things like this, she just make me mad. I say, my sister, have you ever think about it and sit down and see what's this problem is? This person always gets you mad. Maybe it's time for you to move away from that person or work on not to let that stuff get you mad, because you can move away and somebody else can go and piss you off. So learn to not let things make you mad. Take a moment. Just pause and say, you know what? I'm not going to let you upset me. I know you're trying to steal my joy, but I'm not going to give that to you. I'm going to be happy. I'm going to stay strong. So I'll fight, sir. Because I'm not going to give you one piece of me to let you get me all upset. Like the other day, I was at the store. I went to this international store. So I saw this guy. As I opened up one of those, what's they call them, door. They usually have stuff in the freezer. I opened it up. So I saw this brother came behind me. He just kept on staring at me. So I wonder why is he keep staring at me. And his face looked familiar. So he said something to me. He said, excuse me, my sister. He said, where are you from? I said, oh, I'm from Sierra Leone. She said, oh my God, the man just got mad out of nowhere. Oh my God, y'all Sierra Leone people are just like Nigeria people. Everywhere you go, you see Sierra Leone, you see Nigeria. So I'm just looking at this brother. What do me being from Sierra Leone have anything to do with Nigeria? We are everywhere, we're doing this. So he started telling me, Sierra Leone people in Nigeria are always causing trouble. They stay down this one place that I never even been of. I heard of the few people that stay down there, but I ain't never heard of nothing of the stuff that he was saying. He said, y'all just like Nigeria people. Y'all speak a lot of English and this and your language. Yeah, we speak English, we also speak other language. But what does that have to do with me and whatever you're talking about? Because I say I'm from Sierra Leone. He said, I don't like Nigeria people. I don't like Sierra Leone people. I'm not going to say where he's from. I said, my brother, let me ask you one thing. I say, for this, I just want to say this to you. If this is the way you talk to Sierra Leone people that you meet, or the way you talk to Nigeria people that you see, I say, be careful. I say, next time you might not be lucky. You might come up to a brother or a sister, you ask them, where are they from? They might tell you they're from Sierra Leone or from Nigeria, or they might even lie and say they're not from, or they might lie and say they're from Nigeria or they're from Sierra Leone. They might not even be there for them. And then you went off on them the way that you are doing me. They're going to give it to you very good. And you might not be lucky next time. I said, so be careful how you talk to people. Oh no, I just don't like them. He was just going on and on and on. I said, my brother, are you finished? Are you satisfied now? So he just looked at me. So, and just, you know, looking around and stuff. So I start singing a song. I start dancing. If not you dancing. If not you dancing. No tell. Go tell and say, I know they oh, you not see me. If not you dancing. I kept on singing the song. If not you dancing. I kept on singing it over and over. He said, what does that mean? I said, that mean if they sent you, tell them I am not there and you did not see me. If the devil sent you to come steal my joy, tell him that you did not see me. I'm not here, okay? That's what the song meant. I said, have a blessed day, my brother. So when I left, the next day I went to church. Guess who was in church? He was there. I know that face looked familiar. That I didn't see him somewhere in the church or somewhere. So the pastor was praying, and they say, everybody find somebody hands to hold, two by two. If you don't have an extra partner, three, you can join each other. So my husband had went to the bathroom. So I already have a partner. So people who know me, they know that, you know, I have somebody hands to hold. So everybody grabbing people hand. Now he needs somebody hands to hold. Guess who hands he came and joined? My hand. So he's looking at me. I'm looking at him. So I ain't saying nothing. I just smile in my head. Remember, you were just talking to me crazy last Sunday. Now you coming. But that's what I'm thinking in my head. You see? Be careful how you treat people. Be careful. Now I hold his hand. The pastor is saying, pray. For anything negative your enemy has said against you, cancel it. Command it back to sender. So imagine he's right there. And I know he didn't say all type of negative things about me and Sierra people and Nigeria people. So now if I'm going to be praying to cancel and send it back to sender, it's going to be going back to him. You know what I mean? So he's just looking at me when the pastor is praying. His eyes is half open. He's not where he's just kept on looking at me. But at the end of the day, when they said shake hands, he shook my hand very tight. I guess he... like an apology or whatever he was trying to say. But I learned from that, be careful how you talk to people. The people who you look down on, the people you hate, might be the one there for you tomorrow. You might need them tomorrow. But keep this in mind. Don't let nobody steal your joy. Keep your joy. I'm going to end from there. Let's cover this inside the blood of Jesus. Lord, I cover this message that I just did inside the blood of Jesus. Anything you did not put inside this message or put it, Father, I pray that this message will go out there and touch your children's life, oh Lord. Anyone who's going through depression or any type of thing they are going through, sadness, oh Lord, Father, Lord, let this message touch your life and change your life, oh Lord. And anyone who need my help, bring them to me so that way I can help them. Father, Lord, I deep all this prayer inside the blood of Jesus, for in Jesus' name we pray, amen. And ask God to make you a helper so that way you can go out there and help somebody. Bye, love. Share this video. I'll see you guys next Sunday. Love you guys. Bye.